Hello everyone, myself Sarthak Arora. I've been teaching for the last 16-17 years C, C++ and Java. So as Himanshu sir has told you, now we'll start from the OOPS concept. So let me introduce first of all what is exactly OOPS and what is the meaning of classes and objects and everything. So OOPS basically, object oriented programming. Till now you have studied procedural language, which is C. Now we'll see, we'll talk about OOPS, C++ programming language. Before starting, let's have a look the concept of class and object. What is class and what is object? So if we talk about class, because in procedural language we end our C with the concept of structure, and in OOPS we'll start our topic from the classes. Class is what? Class is nothing, it's just a word, or I can say a group of similar objects to represent something. If I talk about animal, if I talk about fruits, fruit and animal, it's a class, it's not an object. Never ever exist physically, never occupy space, and the reverse, like object of its, like if I talk about cat, dog, horse, whatever, they exist physically. They occupy space, having some common behavior and attribute. If I talk about any other object, like if I talk about this marker, it's an object of stationary class. It exists physically. It's a black in color. It's a cylindrical, having some common behavior and attributes. So this is a part of the real life, what object is and what class is. Let's take from the C++ concept, from the programming concept. Class, which is basically in our C++, divided into two groups, data members and member functions. Let me compare a small thing, a complete class, with the structure. In structure, you have covered the structure is a group of only elements. Elements means variables. In case of structure, function, where you input the things, you output the thing, you process the thing, it's an external entity. It never ever the part of the structure. But in case of class, the function becomes the member function, which always part of the class. How the things can be achieved, how the things can be implemented, I give you one small example. I'm writing a small code of structure. As we know, structure is a group of elements. So right now I'm having two variables, roll number and name. And everything is by default public within a structure. Nothing is hidden, which can be easily accessed. By providing the structure variable reference. This S is a structure variable. Which always provides a memory for the elements. S.roll, S.name, whatever you input. Roll number is 12. The name is Neha. The two data, two elements are there. Roll number and name. We have the elements. This is absolutely fine in case of structure. Let me make small change over there. Instead of struct keyword, if I use another keyword, class. The moment you write class over there, compiler will give an error, and the error will be not accessible. the reason behind why. Why it is not accessible? Because now we are studying OOPS. The primary concept of OOPS in C++ is to provide the concept of data hiding. Data hiding means the security of data, which is not in case of structure, because every element, or you can say all the elements, are publicly defined within a structure which can be easily accessed, like it was, we were accessing before it. But in case of class, I write the class keyword over there, I use the class keyword over there. The moment I write a class keyword over there, roll number and name, two elements which were publicly within a structure, now they become header, they become private, which cannot be accessed outside a class. Now the question arises, how we can access it within a function? So I'm having only two ways to access it. Either I make it public, but if I defined publicly within a class, then there is no use of classes, or no use of data hiding. So instead of defining it publicly within a class, what I'll do, I'll define the entire function, complete function, within a class. The moment I define it within a class, it will become a member function. Then I would say class is a group of two things, data member and member function, where structure is only the group of elements. So let me make the class so that we can see how the things can be achieved, how the things can be implemented in C++.